something on your own. You must be involved in IT area, right? So just to introduce myself, I think Akshika gave some introduction. I'm currently a senior fellow in Innovation and Entrepreneurship at University of Moratuwa. In fact, I'm taking over on the 15th of February. So my expertise lies in startups, entrepreneurship, and innovation. But three subjects, if you look at it, it's a very broad one. So what I'll do is today is actually I will focus on innovation. But I'll touch on other areas also, but all depends on the time, right? So, shall I start or should I wait for some time? You can start, right? Okay. The first question, I'm actually like Akshika and but Dinadi, I hope you ask a lot of questions, right? So, I'm doing the same presentation at many places. So. If I don't get any feedback from you guys, what will happen is you might learn something, I won't learn anything. Okay? So me being here from Colombo is to learn something new, right? Not just to give something to you, right? I want to learn something from you guys, right? So if you don't ask questions, I won't learn anything, right? That's the ground rule. Okay? So you have to ask questions. And you can stop me at any time to ask questions, right? Okay. So what is innovation? Can anyone of you tell me the definition of innovation? Clear the innovation definition first. Okay? Innovation, so I'm not asking anything on, say, Oxford level definition, right? I'm asking just a simple explanation. Innovation can right? You can always say the negative on the other side of it, right? So next question would be, what is invention? Invention can work, innovation can work. And is there a difference? Is there a difference? Okay. So second question, is innovation a tricky thing? We got a technology and then I got innovation. Yes or no? Yes, yes, can I do sir? No, right, very good. Innovation is not a techie thing. If you really want to learn about innovation, what is the closest subject matter? Then, up to hardware, electronics, right? If you want to learn about innovation, or if you want to study innovation or to the greater deal, right, what is the subject matter that you have to study? Any idea? Is it computer programming, or is it electronics, or is it IT, or is it science, technology, what is it? Can you give a wide guess? IT ki naya tusa mang innovation gena ha IT gena ganna mang IT karanta are ka kin anybody else science gena gena ganna science right okay the mang gena gena ganna ona hamade gena ganna innovation karan but there's one subject area that you want to really master in order to make innovations. Maybe you don't really learn in that particular subject, but at least you have learned some of the really important things of that subject matter. Can you learn that? That subject matter is called human resource management. So innovation is not a techie thing, it's you're playing with your mindset. Right? Right? If you want to be a innovation boom in a company, right? The first thing that you have to study is HR, human resource management, because you are playing with the mindset of people. Because innovation is a something that you something to do with your mindset, right? That's why you know, in Sri Lanka we are very poor in innovation, right? Very poor in innovation compared to even closest countries. We are very poor in innovation because we don't give that emphasis on the other subject areas when it comes to innovation, right? So I'll move into my basic areas. I'll touch these areas. So since I want to give some definition to innovation, I'll ask you questions again, right? Anyone know this particular incident in the history? Archimedes, right? You know the story about Archimedes, right? Archimedes is a නේද මොකද රත්තරන් ඔටුන්නක් දීලා right රත්තරන් ඔටුන්නේ ඇත්ත රත්තරන්ද කුරු රත්තරන්ද කියලා හන්ට රජුලෝ කිව්වා නේ so he was like නිකන් අර පුරෝහිත වගේ කෙනෙක් නේ is a council නිකන් ජනාධිපති උපදේශක වගේ කෙනෙක් right දැන් කල but the thing is this is so many years ago and there are big consequences right deadly consequences if you don't give the right answer so this guy was you know thinking overnight every day maybe weeks and he couldn't find the answer and then suddenly at one point he realized the answer right ekak welaka naanda lasila thama okkoma danagatte right and he was so happy so thrilled and we call this particular incident me ara idea ekak paata mena eketa now we have a word we call it eureka moment right actual word is epiphany right paata mana light bulb ekak wage idea kene and my question is eureka moment are they innovations? The part of me no ideas of it. Ida again like it. Do they bond with ideas? Do you know? The part of me, number one, like it. Give me ideas. Are those innovations? The part of me, ideas, innovations. That means idea is a innovation. Yes, can I push? No, can I push? Right, very good. Yeah. So the first. That you have to learn, maybe you already know that idea can be innovation, maybe, right? Innovations are not that easy to come by, right? You have a lot of put lot of commitments. It's a long process, lot of time, lot of effort, right? That's the first principle in innovation. Right? Second one, bigger one, what? Can we talk about that? कोई कहा तो बोले तो तूने 1990s थे 1980s थे 1970s थे 2000 तो 1990s नहीं 1990s से हमें कहा तो नहीं दिखा माइक अभी हम ये बताएं बैठ रही है अभी तो यूट्यूब की बैठने आप इतने कहाँ हैं मगर मैंने मैंने इस तो बाउट द रोड ना नशो राइट एस इस द नाइट आगे सत्ता कायोटे राइट कायोटे टाइस इस बड़ी बड़ी के गैजेट था तो ना मैंने It's a lot of gadgets, rocket, try to capture the road done. And you can get by American. One main thing, has he ever captured the road done? Allah Dio Rekha, Allah Dio Rekha, Manna Tam Rekha, Nega Maha. Yes or no? So, what he does, a coyote karna deval innovations. Nariya hadana deval innovations. ඕන ඉනොවේෂන්ස් නැති. Yes කියන අපස. Yes. No කියන අපස. No. In my definition of innovation, he never does an innovation. I'll explain you why. If there's an innovation, you should achieve what you want to achieve. Innovation එක complete වෙන්න නම් वागे वा ट्राई करने दे अचीव करना वो देश उसके यूजर्स एटलिस्ट यूजर्स लाइक नो नो आते थे यूजर्स का नेतना इट इस नॉट एन इनोवेशन इट कैन बी इन्वेंशन ओके सो यू नाउ यू नो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन इन्वेंशन एंड इनोवेशन राइट users are not an innovation act. Nobody is using anything that you have made. Maybe it's a wow product, right? One of the best product that you think that is ever done by the human kind for the last 1,000 years. But if there's nobody is using that particular system or the product, there's no innovation. Okay. Okay. So now you have an idea. So I'm not going to give any definition, but this is how we should look at innovation. Okay. Anybody know about the person called Reid Hoffman? How then? Are you? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes, can I go, sir? How then, any? LinkedIn, can I help you on the software? Sorry, website, right? Social, right? Okay. Facebook, why? What are we not? So this guy is the creator or the inventor or the innovator of LinkedIn. In fact, he's the co-founder of LinkedIn, right? Now this guy is known as a super angel in Silicon Valley, right? Super angel kine kahal ki no? Angels are kine kahal ki no? Angel investors. So I'm just going through entrepreneurship, startups, ecosystem. So in Silicon Valley, right? You know why it's Silicon Valley? Silicon Valley is basically part of California, right? In the US, right? So Silicon Valley, you know the story behind it. It's all started because of the small device called transistor, right? Discovered in 1950s. And then it became the area where they made most of the electronic companies. So that's why it became Silicon Valley. Right? Then Silicon Valley, because Silicon Valley will hang. Why is the Silicon Valley theme? But we still call it Silicon Valley, but where is Silicon Valley now? It's now in the Far East, actually in China. The real Silicon Valley now in 2017 is in China. Like Okoma transistor, Okoma radio, electronics, Okoma and China, right? But still they call it Silicon Valley because it's the area. Of course, it's had a lot of transformations in the same area. They used to do electronics, now they don't do electronics, but in 1980s, 90s, they had a what you call it, internet bubble, right? You can come up with companies, Google, this particular area is now known for innovations, known for startups, known for entrepreneurship, right? Entrepreneurship, startups, at the end, there are so many other things. You have to have the programmers, you have to have the coders, you have to have the IT gurus, you have to have people, you have to have expertise, so many other areas. One major part of startup ecosystem is what you call the investors, right? You have to have investors, people who can throw money at, right? Right? There can be people called VCs, venture capitalists. These are people who manage somebody else's money and they invest. Then there are people who they use their own money for investment. They could have, you know, angels, angel investors. Angel investors, like, you know, would have been in the country, right? Lanka, Namputi, and Avalahara, the Chamath Palipiti, right? Chamath Palipiti is a super angel. Similarly, Reid Hoffman is a super angel. So Reid Hoffman says, again, when a super angel says something, we believe that. And that's what happens in Silicon Valley. When a super angel says something, people believe in that. So what he says is, innovations come from long-term thinking and iterative execution. Right? If you have ideas, innovation, you have iterative process. Right? He was known as the number one management guru in the entire world. You have heard of his name called Stephen Covey. Stephen Covey, he was the number one management guru those days, right? About 3 years ago. But he was the number one management guru. He said, the other principle, if you want to do innovations, right? First you have to have an idea. Right. Then you should have the counteractive idea. And through the counteractive idea, maybe ideas, counteractive ideas, you have to develop the third alternative. An idea ka put a fine tune karana. So kamai innovation ya ke. You have just one perfect idea. Kaat wa kiyan na tu ye idea ka tiyari ki you will never have a innovation. So that's what he said. Okay? So, idea is, innovation is a process. Innovation is not one thing, it's not a simple time frame, it's a long process. Right. Have you heard about a person called Elon Musk? Have you? Actually, he was known, now he is known as Tesla co-founder, but actually he's the co-founder of PayPal. And he used to be the co-founder of PayPal. Then he sold the company, then got a lot of money, and used that money to start a company called, not Tesla, SpaceX. It's a rocket manufacturing company owned by one person, right? He tried 21 times to send a rocket to space, failed 21 times, and now he is successful, finally, right? And at the same time, maybe just few years later, he started a company called Tesla. What the Tesla again? Is it a car company? Is it a car company? Tesla is not a car company, right? It's a electric battery company. Spin-off is a car. Their technology, entire technology relies on the electric battery, right? So all their patents are on electric battery. So what this guy means is 12 years of patents, right? How they will have their patents. 2 years ago what he did was, he did a remarkable thing, right? He gave all these patents to public domain. අවුරුදු 11ක් තිස්සේ ආ හදපු patents එක දැන් එකපාරටම දුන්න ඔක්කොටම ඔන්නා ගන්න කියලා public domain එක දුන්නා. ඔක්කොටම දුන්නා ඔන්න දෙයක් use කරන්න. Right? එකරේ ඇයි කියන එක තාම ගොඩක් අය තේරුම් ගන්න බෑ but if you really know about innovation and the diffusion of innovation theory, right? You know what he did first, what he did. Because innovation doesn't complete if there are no users. විසලයිනේ තමයි ඉනොවේෂන් එකක් කම්ප්ලීට් වෙන්න නම් ගොඩක් අක යූස් කරනවා යූස් කරන එක ගොඩාක් අක යූස් කරන්න පුළුවන් නම් same thing it becomes a very successful innovation right so what he did was he knew that Tesla can bring a really good car yes definitely but if others also can bring similar I mean they can develop from what he has learned and develop a far better car or maybe if his knowledge becomes like open source to everyone, then there's a better, faster rate of innovations. So that's what he wanted to do. So he put everything that he has gained, learned, all the IP rights to as public domain, right? Now, significant thing about Tesla is, now, when it comes to innovation, there are various areas that you can do innovations, right? The Lankawe, මූද වටේ මාළු අල්ලන්න ලේසි කියලා කියනවානේ. ඇයි කියලා දන්නවනේ? ලංකාවේ මූද වටේ තමයි මිනිස්සු හැම එකනම වෙන ඉන්දියාවේ මාළු කාරය යනවා, ලංකාවේ මාළු කාරය යනවා, රණ්ඩු වෙනවා, සමහර අය අල්ලන් යනවා. Then there are about 150 trawlers from Japan hovering around Sri Lankan Indian Ocean. ලංකාව වටේ කරගෙන හැමදා. So it's an area where a lot of fish. Then there's a lot of fish what happens? Lot of competition, right? Competition වැඩි ගොඩක් මාළු. So ඒ වගේ දේවල් තමයි innovations වලත් තියෙන්නේ. If you do something, example, I can give an example. If you do an e-commerce site nowadays, right? E-commerce site. Gudak katti edo wage deval karana. Right? E-commerce site karana ota lagi. Wow.lkki, mydeal.lkki, takas.ci, gudak katti. So there's a heavy competition. Right? But ekat ekak podi podi prashna deyak kena. Maybe your marketing budget grows bigger. Right? Wage samahara deval thiyena. Maybe pennane kiyala. Ara ගැඹුරු මුහුදේ ඉන්න ලොකු මාළු අල්ලන්න යන්න පුළුවන් නම් right ගැඹුරු මුහුදේ ඉන්න ලොකු මාළු අල්ලන්න යන්න පුළුවන් නම් they are difficult to catch right you can't see them easily right there's a bigger chance of doing bigger innovations so person like Tesla right person like Elon Musk right what they do is they fish in the deep ocean ඒගොල්ලෝ හදන දේවල් එකපාරට පේන්නේ මොකද්ද මේ කරන්න යන්නේ කියලා right එකපාරට කටියට පේන්නේ but once you fish that fish right once you capture that fish it becomes a huge innovation, right? Loku loke loku wenasak karanna puluwan dewal thamai igolak. So if you want to do innovation, try your best to focus on innovations that comes with, you know, not that is obvious, right? If you do obvious innovations, there is a lot of competitions. If you partner with someone, there will be followers. If you copy it, cut it, right? Then what happens is very difficult to keep up that innovation, keep up that into the next market because there is a lot of competition, and your marketing budget will become really big. Okay, so just understand the difference, right? So yeah, you can do a lot of innovations, but innovations have different types, right? If you do innovations in that, you know, Tesla type innovations, right? It has always the chance of making it a huge change in the entire world. Okay, so innovation also has other types, right? As I said, there can be incremental innovations, right? You can do incremental innovations. And there's another type of innovation we call disruptive innovations. You are using them everyday life. అది హా కేలవే ఏది అనేక దగ్గర కనబడుతుంది అక్కడ ఆలోచన అంశం అక్కడ వ్యక్తి అది ప్రాపర్టీస్ రైట్ దగ్గర తీరు దగ్గర ప్రాపర్టీస్ దగ్గర తీరు మీకైనా ఒక గురించి కదా అన్నా ఇన్ 2000 ఐ కెన్ రిమెంబర్ ఇన్ 2002 ఎవ్రీవన్ వాస్ యూజింగ్ నో 2001 ఎవ్రీవన్ వాస్ యూజింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ సడన్లీ 2002 విదిన్ అ వన్ ఇయర్ స్పాన్ అండ్ టోక్ ఫర్ శ్రీలంక రైట్ The same change happened, changed a few years ago in US and other countries, but in Sri Lanka, people were using floppy disks up to 2001. Suddenly in 2002, you couldn't see so many business units, right? You know, TV had a business, you know, PlayStation, Xbox, it was one of the biggest business units they had was this Walkman business. In the 1980s, everyone used to use a Walkman. But suddenly, again, a person called Steve Jobs came and made a thing called iPhone. Maybe it's coming up. iPod. Kid, actually, it came not only that. Lot of other companies came up with technology called MP3. How do you know? They are using it, right? MP3. Kid, it's a high quality audio version of, you know, storing music. So that became a disruptive innovation, right? And that. The result of that was Walkman kiyana gana market ekak nathuwa thiyala kiyala within a few period of time, right? Yeah, so there was another picture in there, right? You saw a car there. So what is that car? There's a car. It's also one of the disruptive innovations that happened about 100 years ago. The car came out again. History of the car came out again. Yeah, so the car came out again. The car came out again. But this particular car was a disruptive innovation, one of the most known disruptive innovations in the world. T model, T15 model. Ford kiyala company hadu American company ka. Henry Ford kiyala kene ka hadu. It's a Ford T15 model. This is the first mass production car in the world. Kita ra ra. Then car hadan ya nagar Japan em tiyenne. Chain ekak tiyenne kene ka illa. Kelima nat ekak thada gama illa ne ilange ekena thamai thara ekak karanne. That entire concept was brought by Henry Ford with this model. This is a disruptive innovation. We need to call it a car thing. right? Daimler car hadua, Benz car hadua. But the thing is, those cars are very expensive. Then car ekak hariyata helicopter ekak ganna wage, then hama kena helicopter ekak ganna ben, right? E wage meka hari expensive cars, but when this car was introduced, it was one of the most affordable cars. Entire market was disrupted. Meka inda nathi vechchade mokada? I said disruptive innovations comes with a tagline. Earlier product will vanish from the market. Making the netiche product is that. Any ideas? Asaka. Ida kali misu innovations kare, ni asya ko mada haiye dua ni. Asya na kadala denna da bolu denna. Those are the innovations. Those are the incremental innovation theory. Go the look at the body. Are you? Father, it's wooded another the body. So that was the innovations thinking those days for incremental innovations. Right? But Henry Ford came and entirely changed the concept of cars and go to disruptive innovation. Take a car like that, take a part of me, or look at the hack. Asagara, the natural gap. The power of disruptive innovations. Innovations, there is another part that you have to understand. There is a very important area called social innovations, right? That's something that very important part of innovation, right? Social innovations, only difference is, again, it's an innovation, but the result is the public good, right? Making an innovation is a public good, right? But it doesn't mean social innovation doesn't mean that you can't make profit, right? Social innovations can make profit. Social innovations can CSR. It's not. Social innovations, you can make profit. But only thing, the result is a public. Like one of the few examples are there. This is a Sri Lankan guy called Dr. Godokumbura. That's one of his innovations. And then this one, you can't see the entire thing, but it's this from Sudan. Sudan, so this, most of the water resources are very far away, right? So normally ladies travel maybe 6-7 miles, right? Carrying huge pots, right, on their head to get water. Maybe water enough for 1 week for the entire family, right? They carry amount of water. So there's one. NGO came in with a small innovation, right? That theater put them on the mind, but they go there for a building. So that's why I said innovation doesn't come with technology. Technology is just an enabler for innovation, right? Technology here are too high tech and done on that. There are very simple things that you can make big innovations. In another thing, an example, it's a, I think it's an airport. Computing and the body system, right? So these are all examples of social innovations. I just want to touch this one. If you are into innovations, think about this line of also. Social innovations can play a big role in the entire world. Maybe it's you are just trying out a niche segment, but that even that niche segment, what you do can be a big thing in the entire world. You can do a huge change in the entire world through social innovations. So innovation as a subject is a huge subject area, right? And there are various matrices that try to identify the innovation capability of a person, of an area, of a company, sometimes even a country. There are ranking systems in innovation capability. You make a one maker, it's a huge exercise, right? There's a lot of subject matter related to innovation. That's why I said it's a more closer to HR side, human resources. One of the biggest things that they have identified when it comes to innovation is diversity. Diversity can have to come back. Right? Then, equal number of girls and boys, diversity is high. Piriplama itara kitiyot, diversity aagi. The whole of them, it was in 1990s, so it was in China. So, it was diversity. Mama, I am bringing diversity to this audience. I born in about 10 years before you, right? And එක එක ජාති වල එකතු වුණාම සිංහල විතරක් නම් මෙතන ඉන්නේ ඩයිවර්සිටි ආයි right සිංහල මුස්ලිම් හැමෝම ඔක්කොම එකතු වෙලා ඉනවනම් එතන ඩයිවර්සිටි එක වැඩි. එතකොට කොළඹ කට්ටිය විතරක් නම් මෙතන ඉන්නේ නැත්නම් ගමේ කට්ටිය අඳුනා අනිත් ගමේ කට්ටිය විතරක් නම් මෙතන ඉන්නේ ඩයිවර්සිටි ආයි thank you get the point right so if you want to increase innovation in a country you need to have high diversity right that's a known fact right which research so much in lot of areas and I think right diversity is a primary attribute of innovation so e wage dewal wedi karanna puluwa kawa godak kamathi ala kam da this is the most important area right how you increase innovation maybe in a country maybe in a area maybe in a university now if it's over Wellassa how do you increase innovation capability of over Wellassa padagranna innovation medical anda mona diversity right eka deyak amaru ekak inda man kiyata innovation medical anda karanna puluwan ek example ekak idea pollution idea pollution කියන කාරණා idea something you know or industrial revolution started in the 16th century දාර්ශනික විප්ලවයේ කොන්ස්ටන්ටිනෝපල් නගරයට ඇවිල්ලා ඒ ලයිබ්‍රරි කියවිලා මිනිස්සු කතා කරා that's the closest reason the means එකල කතා කරා මිනිස්සු තමන්ගේ දේවල් ෂෙයා කරා යුනිවර්සිටිස් හැදලා තියෙන එකට යුනිවර්සිටි හැදලා තියෙන ලෙක්චර්ස් යන්න දෙන්නේ යුනිවර්සිටි හැදලා තියෙන්නේ මේ එක්සෑම් කරන්න නෙමෙයි යුනිවර්සිටිස් හැදලා තියෙන්නේ මිනිස්සුන්ට කතා කරන්න තමන්ගේ අයිඩියාස් කතා කරන්න අයිඩියාස් කතා කරන්න නේද මේ අල්ප බලපෑම නැහැ අයිඩියාස් කතා කරන්න තමයි යුනිවර්සිටිස් තියෙන්නේ right and the biggest universities in the world if you name like places like Stanford places like Harvard ඒවල තියෙන්නේ කතා කරන්න when you go to that university you get lot of time to talk to each other and share your ideas that's where the starting point of innovation idea question idea question mein toh kata kiya na that's something 70 gana and then 70 gana 1970s there was a guy called not remember the name but he was he's the father of www world wide web right namada I also can't remember but I tell you the story so he namada Tim Berners-Lee yes correct yeah good so Tim Berners-Lee had this idea of www you know the difference between www and internet right it's a two different thing right so he had the idea of www the html right hypertext markup language he had the idea in early 1970s right abeya kaata kiwe na eya igenama hita hita godak kalika develop kara eya taniyama develop kara abeya podi podi develop mata kara ma kaata kiwe na so it took nearly 10 years for him to innovate www එක අන්තිම කාලයට කීපෙනෙක් එක්ක කතා කරලා පොඩ්ඩක් ෂෙයා කරන්න පස්සේ තමයි found the missing piece of his innovation so the simple idea is if once www came up the entire world changed that you all know right ලෝකෙ සම්පූර්ණ වෙනස් වුණා දැන් උනත් ලෝකෙ ගොඩාක් දේවල් innovations වැඩි වෙන්න හේතුවක් කියලා කියනවා මේ internet එකයි www world wide web එකද people can now share a lot of ideas right so because of these two innovations have now climbed in an exponential curve right sir kitta kitta ho podi podi gradual deval from 1980s now it's an exponential curve ama tanama loku deval ena internet bubble ek aave dekhi right and everywhere you see innovation right that's the reason is now people there are better methods for people to share ideas right sir call lamp gala ganne sir kata karana deval now people have even to talk to people in US people in UK people in Australia sir it's an easy thing because of the internet ideas share කරන්නේ තමයි innovations වැඩි ලක්. So it's a one key thing. So you are in university, you have an idea, share that with your best friend, right? Then we get the very long way. Cultural pressure, you know, because the cluster in the teacher got again. What did again? We can even act on it. Someone get it, someone can even act on it. Right? Out of penalty, someone with the time. It's not the same meaning, but the idea is if you have an idea, right, you should be able to share it. Someone done the entire key with it. Someone done ideas and then given it on share. It's all the mind. The idea is fine tuned to the innovation. Especially if you are in university, try to do that. Right? Don't keep your ideas to yourself. You will die with your idea. You know me? What idea you are young into Tanimo, idea take a merit. So don't keep your idea with yourself. Always share that idea and try to fine tune that idea with the help of others. So collaboration makes a huge difference in innovation. Because I mean, the founders like in the Silicon Valley. Silicon Valley is a founders. Silicon Valley is a co-founder. Even Mark Zuckerberg also known as a co-founder of Facebook. So how can they make the idea? He may be the main brain behind everything, but then there are co-founders. But I mean, cannot come to that kind of innovation. I'll come to that also in the next slide. Innovation is not just a product, right? Then you should be able to market it, right? Marketing calendar. Then you should be able to do business analysis, business studies, legal. So one person can't have all the capabilities of innovation. Entire life cycle. That's why co-founders makes a difference. Computer scientists innovation. So try to get people outside from your comfort area. Again, you can co-founder. And you have a product, bring someone from totally different area which you lack. That means a huge thing. So one thing, do you know this curve? It's one of the important things when it comes to innovations. So this theory says, don't try to sell your product to these people. But try to sell your product to these people. Very important. Early adopters. How the early adopters get? Any community, 30 people are called early adopters. Very important. Opinion leaders. Opinion leaders in the Hamkan. Gami is called the opinion leader. Right? Skolamante Mahara Kikotema Gami Ida. Lot of people believe in that. Not that everyone believes it. Samara Skolamante in the Piriga, but Skolamante Mahara Kikotema maker, Hundai Kikotema, would have that Piriga. But Gamakanan Gambula. School ekana principal, right? Hari company ekana ange atloku senior manager kene kiya dewa piliganna, right? These people are calling opinion leaders. The opinion leaders tama adura ganna. So if you have a product, and you want to have 1 million apps, you have to identify who are the opinion leaders for your product and start selling your app to those opinion leaders. They go under the name of that's called marketing skill. Take it was important one. Then what happens is automatically these people start selling that to Yagi Kakti Punan. Right? They can be happy with that. Happy. They got taken to what I mean to Rakati Rama. Make a good argument the best artist of this knowledge is actually politicians. So they know theory of marketing, theory of innovation. It's part of theory of innovation, actually, right? Because innovation, you can't have innovation without marketing. If you don't know marketing, forget about innovation. On the product at birth, on the wow product at birth, people won't buy it. You have to have marketing knowledge. So this is pure marketing. So these are the skills that you have to develop if you want to be an innovator, if you want to be an entrepreneur, if you want to be a startup co-founder or startup leader. Right? If I say that, yeah, once you have the early adopters believe in your product, then yes, ඔයගොල්ලන්ට ඔයගොල්ලන්ගෙත් මොනවද කියලා නම් you can partner with someone මගේ දිහා ඇඩ් කරගන්න. I can give my expertise lies in not really in technology, although my background is electronics engineering, but my expertise lies in marketing, product development, and getting investors. Those are the expertise that I have. So I wish that there's a bit of a gap even at University of Moratuwa in those three areas. So I wish that gap with the people at University of Moratuwa. A lot of people have a lot of talent in technology, but I wish that gap in terms of marketing, product development, and bringing investors. So that's the area that I'm working right now. So if you have any product idea, startup idea, some innovation that you want to market or bring it to next level, you can contact me.